quite often with an education and healthcare plan, we don't always agree with the decisions that are made. So there are rights to appeal through the SEND, the Special Educational Needs SEND Tribunal. You can appeal lots of the different stages of an EHCP, and that starts at the very early stage when you apply. So if you apply for a needs assessment and the local authorities say, no, we're not doing one, you have a right to appeal that decision. If they agree to assess, but then don't agree to issue a plan, you can appeal that decision. Let's say they've given you a plan and you've got the draft in front of you and you want changes made, but the local authority don't agree and they finalise the plan and you're not in agreement with certain sections within the plan, you can appeal that. There are only certain sections of the plan that you can appeal, and they are section B, which is the special educational needs of the child, section F, which is the provision, and section I, which is the name of the school that's in the plan. You can, if you are taking either of those sections or any of those sections to appeal, sections B and F, sorry, you can also appeal the health and social care sections of an education and healthcare plan, but you can't appeal those on their own. They must be alongside section B and F. So let's say you take an appeal to the SEND tribunal and you're appealing section B and F, but you also want to query what's in the health and social care sections, you can bring those along to the appeal as well. Unfortunately, a tribunal cannot legally enforce your requests within the health and social care sections, but they can make recommendations to a local authority, and they would really realistically expect that a local authority did listen to their recommendations. You can appeal after an annual review. So if you've had a review of the plan and the local authority decide to keep it as it is and you want amendments making, or they decide to amend it but you want to keep it the same, or they decide that they're going to cease to maintain the plan, you can appeal all of those decisions. It's really important that you take heed of the letter that comes with any decisions that they make. So at any of those points, you will receive a letter from the local authority telling you of their decision. Let's go with they are not going to issue an EHCP. So they will send you a letter, and that letter should contain all of your rights to appeal and how you go about that. What you often find, or what you will find, is that as part of the appeals process, you will have to consider mediation. You don't have to go to mediation. It's often a really good idea because it's an opportunity to talk to the local authority and an independent person about what your concerns are, and they can often be sorted out without the need to go through the tribunal process. But if you decide not to go to mediation, they will issue you with a certificate that then gives you the go ahead to take it to a tribunal. There are strict timescales for appealing, and it's 2 months from the date of the letter that you get, or 1 month from the mediation letter or certificate, whichever is the later. There are certain times when those timescales are different, but you would get a letter with the decision and it will outline the tribunal rights and the timescales in there.